My name's Phil Ewels. On behalf of the organisers, I'd like to welcome you to the NF Core Hackathon for March 2025. This is a short video just introducing the hackathon, explaining how things will work, and walking through some of the steps that you'll need to take over the next few days. Firstly, a phenomenal number of people have registered for the hackathon this year. 973 at the time of recording, this is the Friday, so it's my hope that we'll reach 1,000 by Monday. It's just a fantastic number of people who have decided to turn up this week and join us, so thank you for that. You're spread across 44 different local sites all the way around the world, and nearly half of you are joining from online from countless locations. This is by far a record. We've seen these online hackathons grow year on year from 2022, and this year we've nearly doubled in size since 2024. That is amazing. So everyone give yourself a pat on the back for being part of something huge. Looking at the answers to the questions we asked you in the registration survey, as is the pattern for these events, the vast majority of you are here for the first time. So welcome and hope you enjoy your first ever NF Core hackathon. Many of you have never contributed to NF Core either, and that's fine. There should be lots for you to do and lots for you to learn. And the hope is by the end of a hackathon, you'll be confident and ready to contribute on a regular basis. That's how many of us got involved in the first place. If we look at the demographics, many of you are young and we've got a pretty good gender balance, so that's really nice to see. And if we look at the different local sites, there's a really good spread of attendance. Most sites have somewhere between 10 and 20 people there. These local sites really are spread out all over the world this year. So those of you who are listening earliest in the day down in Australia and New Zealand, well done and thank you for organising the first ever local hackathon sites in those regions. Also in San Francisco, many in South America, we've got several in Africa, just fantastic spread around the world. And this is really what we hope for with these events, is to be truly inclusive and diverse and global. If we look at who's attending, there's many of you in Europe, but we've also got a really good spread all the way around the world. The sun will never set on the NF Core Hackathon. Wherever you are in the world, there should be people up and working at the same time as you. On that note, let's have a quick look at the schedule. We'll do one wrap-up at the end of each day, just to have a quick overview of the kinds of things that people have been working on. Because we're spread across so many time zones, there'll actually be three wrap-ups for the three different parts of the world. One in Asia Pacific, one in Europe, and one in the Americas. Check the NF Core website on the Hackathon event page to see when these are, and hopefully there'll be a little box telling you what those times are in your local time zone as well. In addition to the wrap-ups, we're also going to have a quiz. There's two quiz events in the hope that we can cover all those spans, and that will be on Tuesday. So look out for that and make sure you join us. It's a lot of fun. Okay, so how does the hackathon work? What do you actually do? First things first is you go to the NF Core website on the hackathon page and you look through all the different projects and you pick one. I'll go into all of these in more detail in a second. Once you've chosen a project, you go to the Slack channel for that group, introduce yourself and say why you've picked that project. Next, go to GitHub under the NF Core organization and find the list of issues that have been added for that project and see if there's something there that interests you. Find a specific issue and assign yourself to that issue on GitHub. You go and select your username and put it next to that issue so that no one else starts working on the same thing and we don't duplicate work. Now the fun bit, get in and open your code editor and start writing some code. Make sure you chat to everybody else, see if you can join up with other people doing similar tasks. And when you're finished, commit the code, push it to your fork, and open up a pull request against the main repository. Once it's all finished, it's merged, make sure you note down some record of what you did, be it chatting in the project Slack channel, and there's also going to be a Google Slides with one slide per project for each day for that wrap up. Okay, so how do you actually choose a project in the first place? If you go to the NF Core website, you'll see there's a list of all the different projects that people have submitted. There's quite a long list and they're roughly categorized into different categories like pipelines and so on. If you click on any of these, you'll get a little pop-up modal, which tells you more about that project, specifically the kinds of things they're aiming to do, the goals, and who the organizers are. You can then click through to any of those people to chat to them on Slack if you have any questions. Most importantly, look out for the button in the bottom right that says Go to Slack channel. Every single project has a specific Slack channel associated with it, and that's where the majority of discussion will happen during the hackathon about the work you're doing. So Slack, let's talk about that for a minute. Slack is really central both to our community and also to this event. If you haven't already, stop this video right now and go to the NF Core website and sign up and register for the NF Core Slack. You'll find a link there. You sign through, it's free, it should be easy to do. Once you're in, look for a channel called Hackathon March 2025. This is the main Slack channel for the hackathon. All the announcements will go out there, and also we hope all of you will chat there as much as possible. The best thing that we can have is lots of activity there. So when people log in and they're feeling a little lost, they'll see that lots of people are involved in the hackathon and there's lots going on and they'll be excited. Drop any questions. Don't feel this is just for official business. Just chat, post pictures, whatever. This is the hub of activity for the whole event. In addition to that main channel, as I said, there's a specific channel for every project and you can find that through the website. Because this hackathon spans so many different sites, so many different time zones, and nearly half of you are online, even if you're at a local site, please make sure you're paying attention to Slack and you're online all the time, because there may be people in other locations who are joining in and asking questions about your project. If you want to chat to someone, pop your headphones on and jump into a Slack huddle or whatever is easiest. If you want to use Zoom or Google Meet or whatever, that's fine. Slack huddle is this button you'll see in the Slack channel top right with a pair of headphones. You click on that and it opens up a little video call with anyone in that conversation. People can hop in and out as they wish, and it's all within Slack, so you don't need to add any special software or anything. Okay, I mentioned finding issues on GitHub. The way you do that is with a GitHub project. If you go to github.com/nfcore, you'll see along the top bar, projects. Click on projects and you should find one called Hackathon March 2025. In there, there's different tabs and different views of all the different issues across the whole hackathon that people intend to work on. Find your category, find your project in the side, and you should see a list of all the different issues that the project leads have set up ready to be worked on. This is the finest grain detail. You can go through there, find tasks to do, assign yourselves, and check them off when they're done. You can also add new tasks here. This list is far from complete, so if there's not much there, you can start the hackathon off by thinking up all the different things you'd like to do and adding new issues for them so they can be ticked off. This is a real living document as we go through. We know all these issues are not going to be finished by the end of a hackathon, and that's fine, don't worry about it. It's best to have lots of issues in there if possible. Finally, at the start of a hackathon, it's great if we can have a kickoff for each of the projects. Project leads, this is really for you to organise. If possible, the best thing to do is just to record a short video of yourself talking about the project and explaining the kinds of things you had in mind when you proposed it. Again, you can do this in Slack. There's a button right next to where you type saying record video message. Click that, chat into the camera for a couple of minutes and you're done. That will be posted to the Slack channel and everyone can watch that, doesn't matter what time zone they're in. In many cases, it'll make sense to have a kickoff discussion as well, where you get everybody involved and chat about what needs to be done and people can ask questions. You can do that via Slack huddle, but because of the time zone thing, we recommend using Zoom for that and clicking record. Once you've finished, you can drop that recording into Slack, and again, anyone can watch it, even if they're waking up 12 hours later. So what happens if there isn't a project in that list that you want to work on, or you're expecting to work on something and you can't find it there? That's fine. You just need to add a new project to the NFCore website. On the Hackathon event webpage, you'll see all the instructions about how to do that. It's basically opening a pull request against the website with a markdown file, with a few fields at the top. It should be pretty easy to do. You can do that anytime, even if it's at the end of the day, right at the end of the hackathon, you can still add a new project. Pop it in there and then people can find it and it will be more discoverable for the rest of the community. It doesn't matter if you're the primary maintainer of a pipeline, for example. If you have a project that you want to work on and you're happy to lead that and help other people, add it to the website. Let us know on the website channel to merge that pull request in when you're ready with it. Okay, at the end of each day, we're going to do the daily wrap-ups. This is a meeting where basically everybody checks in wherever you are, and we just chat about the kinds of things we've done during a day. Because there are so many of you, this year we're going to try and keep it brief and have one slide in a Google Slides deck per project, where the project lead or someone they nominate chats for a maximum of 1 minute about the kinds of things that people have been working on that day. It's not detailed, it's not comprehensive, it's just to give a flavour and feel like you're part of a big event with lots of other people. Perhaps most importantly is we have a high bar for entertaining content in NFCore, so we expect to see lots of memes and GIFs and silliness and photos and selfies, so make it fun. This is not about going into a technical deep dive on the pull request code you've been working on, it's just to give a flavour and have a bit of fun at the end of the day. These meetings can also act as a check-in depending on what time zone you're in. So if there's a meeting happening in the morning, it can act as a handover from one time zone to the next. Finally, something we found to be really, really beneficial for these events is pair programming. This is especially good for people working online. Grab someone, preferably in your project, but it can be anyone, you can just post in the main hackathon channel and ask if they want to pair program with you. Then you jump into a Slack huddle or whatever video call, load up VS Code, and using this extension from Microsoft called Live Share, you can share a single code editor and work on a project together, both of you editing the same code and using the same terminal. Even if you're not editing the same code at the same time, it can be fun to hang out in a video call and just chat to someone as you're working, and share problems and ideas as you go along. Really encourage this, especially for people online. If you can't find anyone, drop a message on Slack and see if anybody else is also looking for a pair programming partner. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the end of a cycle. You've written your code, you've pushed it to GitHub, it's ready to go. You open your pull request and you feel victorious. You're not quite finished yet. Once that pull request is submitted, it needs to be reviewed by someone else, preferably not your best mate, but someone else in the community who can give it an objective read over. Once they're happy with it, they approve the pull request, it gets a little green tick, and then it can be merged, and then you're finished. If you don't see the option to be able to review a pull request and give it an official review, it's probably because you're not part of an NFCore GitHub organization. There's a Slack channel called GitHub Invitations. You go there, post your GitHub username, and someone will add you to the NFCore GitHub org right away. And then you'll have permission to make reviews and merge pull requests. If you find that your pull request has been sat there for a little while and is feeling a bit unloved, the best thing you can do is find a review buddy. Lots of people are putting in pull requests all the time. So find someone else who's just put theirs in and swap with them, and you can review each other's code and no one is left waiting. We have a Slack channel dedicated for this called Request Review. This is not specific to a hackathon. This is used all year round to find other people to help review your code. Okay, onto the fun stuff. Let's talk about the socials. This year we've got a few different things lined up for you. The first one is Scavenger Hunt. There's a Slack channel called Hackathon March 2025 Scavenger Hunt, and Fran will be posting messages throughout each day with different challenges. All you have to do is go and take a photo of whatever the thing is, post it to the Slack channel and see if you can get a few laughs. You can post as many pictures as you want. You can be as venturous as you want. It can just be a selfie of you at your desk, or you can really go to town and do something outrageous. It's up to you. It's just a bit of fun, and it's a really good way to connect with people in other locations. We also have a game which has been written for the NFCore community. If you go to the NFCore website, click community, you'll find an option there called Connect Game. Drop in there and you get a little browser-based game which you can play. It's simple, but it's quite a lot of fun. We have a Slack channel called Connect Game. If you get a good high score, take a screenshot and dump it into that Slack channel, and we can have a little competition running over the hackathon. At the end, whoever gets the highest score will get a mention in the wrap-up, and there might be some prizes. Okay, next, central to any hackathon, of course, is the playlist. We have an official NFCore hackathon playlist on Spotify, and there's a Slack channel called Spotify Playlist. You go there and there are some special slash commands where anyone can add songs to the playlist. It's quite eclectic, and put your headphones on for some good tunes. Okay, next up, we have the quiz. This is happening on Tuesday, wherever you are, and you can join on Zoom. You'll find the link on the NFCore website events webpage. The person running the quiz will share their screen and you'll see the questions come up there, and then on your computer or on your phone you answer the multiple choice questions as quickly as you can. Very simple, it's a lot of fun, so join us there and we'll see if we can break a new record for how many people joining an online quiz at once. Finally, for those of you at a local site, Sakura is sponsoring pizzas or some other kind of food for you, so hopefully your site organizers will know all about that, and on one of the days you'll be able to have a bit of a fun social with your local site. Enjoy. On the topic of freebies, hopefully those of you at local sites may have also had some stickers. I'd like to shout out to Lewis at Sakura, who's designed this fantastic range of new hero stickers for this event, which are really, really fun. You'll also see the champion stickers along the bottom for winners of our socials. And this screenshot is taken from the NFCore website, nfcore/stickers, which is like a gallery of all the different stickers we've designed for all the different events over the years, as well as all the different pipeline stickers. If you click on any of them, you'll see ones like this, which is the official March 2025 hackathon. Grab it, wear it with pride, and stick it on your laptop. Okay, a quick note on some safety. By joining this event, you're agreeing to adhere to our code of conduct. You can find this on our website like everything else. It's all pretty common sense. Ask before taking screenshots of people, ask before taking photos of people so you have their consent, and don't troll people. And of course, remember to take breaks. If you're watching this before or at the start of the event, here's a little checklist of everything you need to have prepped. First, make sure you've read the code of conduct and you're happy with the rules. Second, if you haven't already, join the NFCore Slack. Go and find that Hackathon March 25 channel and add yourself so you can join in with all the discussion. Next, register on GitHub if you haven't, it should be free, and join the NFCore organization by going to that GitHub invitation Slack channel and posting your new GitHub username. Next, make sure you're set up for local development. You've got Nextflow installed, you've got the NFCore command line tool set up, which is from Python package index or by Conda, and some way to run software, so Docker or Singularity or Conda or Mamba or whatever. Alternatively, if you'd like to, you can also run all of this using GitHub Codespaces. That runs online in a sandboxed environment, and you get a certain number of hours for free with GitHub. This is what we use for the training, and it's really effective. Drop us a question on Slack if you have any problems. Okay, and finally, open up all the different browser tabs, make sure you've got the event webpage listed, and make sure you know where to find different documentation and resources, because those are really important. On that note, on the NFCore website, you'll find a huge amount of material. One page which can be really good if you're new to NFCore is the bite-sized talk section. We do an approximately weekly talk, where it tends to be about 15 minutes long, on all kinds of different topics. Some of them are about specific pipelines, some of them are things like how to open your first ever pull request on GitHub, all different types of topics. There are now well over 80 or 90 of these bite-sized episodes, stretching back several years, and they cover a massive amount of information. So have a look there, you might find some topics which are interesting or useful. We try and put every single talk we do for NFCore up on YouTube, so check out our channel on YouTube, youtube.com/c/NFCore. There's also a Nextflow YouTube channel which has a lot of content too. The Nextflow training especially has had a lot of work done on it recently. We have a totally new course for beginners called Hello Nextflow, which has just recently come online. We had an official Nextflow training week a couple of weeks ago, and we launched new videos for all the different chapters of a Hello Nextflow training, where you can join me to go through all the different material together. If you're totally swamped and you're new to Nextflow and you're sat at this hackathon thinking, I don't really know where to start, I don't understand any of the code I'm looking at, might be worth having a look over here. And if you spend 3 days going through the Nextflow training, that's probably time really well spent. This isn't the only training course you'll find at training.nextflow.io. There are also courses specifically for genomics, looking at variant calling with GATK, courses for RNA-seq, courses for NF-test, courses for NF-core, and there's an advanced Nextflow training covering more advanced topics. So well worth a look. I don't want to talk too long because I know everyone is eager to get stuck in and start coding themselves. So finally, I'd like to say a huge thank you to our sponsors. Sakura are paying for pizza at the local sites, as well as doing all the hackathon stickers, so huge thanks to Sakura for making this happen. And I'd also like to thank AWS, who help us with credits, which run our continuous integration tests and much, much more. And also new this event, Nebius, is helping us with GPU computing. So if you're interested in working with GPUs, check out the GPU NFCore hackathon project, where you can get free access to GPU cluster during the course of the event. I'd also like to say a huge thank you for everyone involved in making this event happen. The local hackathon organisers who are making all the different local sites all the way around the world happen, thank you. Also, everyone who submitted a project and is being a project organiser. Although you may not have known about it, last week we had an annual spring cleaning event where many of the NFCore maintainers group put a lot of time into cleaning up GitHub, merging or closing old pull request issues, and making sure that everything on GitHub and Slack was ready to go for the hackathon. It was a massive amount of work last week, so thank you all of the maintainers for that. If you're interested in the kinds of things they did, there's a blog post on the NFCore website which recaps all the different activities. Similarly, I mentioned there's new training material. There's been a lot of work put into the training, so thank you everyone for who's involved with that. And also thank you to the NFCore core team and the outreach team who have put a huge amount of work into organising this event and making it happen. There's a lot that goes on behind the scenes to make events this size take place. We really appreciate all the hours you've put in. Finally, thank you for joining. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for turning up and making NFCore what it is. Enjoy the hackathon, have fun, and see you at the end.